Beanoblack, folks, and basically what we're doing is we're zoomed in on two stars, okay? And you can see those two stars. Now, if there's one that's smaller, it might be faint and behind the objects. Now, the number one thing you have to realize is the idea that any object in space that we've known of so far puts off the same size shadow of itself to whatever the light that is available in space. Now, we don't know if this is 1000% constant all the time, but no matter what, this is not a black hole. And that's what I'm trying to tell people about black holes, is the idea that if you see stars and there is darkness, then there is an object and its shadow, and or other objects and its shadows. And what we're going to do is we're going to zoom out. I could zoom in a little bit more on these stars, and we'll go with that. I'll try to max out here. I don't know if I got it in the frame in the shot, but you can see those are two stars, okay? And stars, thank God, no matter how you image them, they put out the same type of array, basically a cross. And I'm not going to get in trouble with religion anyway, because I'm not a total atheist. So here we go with the idea, the actual factual, that there's two stars. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom down. And yes, I've got it on paint, but I don't touch pictures up at all. What I do is I use it to go into and be able to zoom in on something massively, because what I can go one screen, zoom in, and then you go to another screen, zoom in, and you can just zoom in like crazy. So what we did is we zoomed in on this. Basically, that was there. And I'll just zoom in a little bit more, and then you'll see that basically there's the timestamp and everything like that, and today's shot. And I'm going to go back up here. And actually, that's showing the 11th/8th, because that's where it's framed at, but I have a conglomeration of a couple days here that I'm zoomed in on. And yes, the sun's over to the right. Basically, the sun's over here in this shot. That's what I'm zoomed in on, to the left. There's all kinds of massive good zooming you can do. And from a far distance, you even somewhat know that there's some planets there, because you can see these combines of their shadow and more than possibly one planet, and so forth and so on. And then you can zoom in and you can find out the stars that are actually there. You'll know that it's a star that's there. And I can bring it down. And when you get really zoomed in, you lose positioning, but there we go. And there's your numbers. Basically, we'll scan back up. And then that's the two stars we were zoomed in on there. And there's another star there to the left. But as you can see, that there's a planet around this one, it's to the back side of that star, if there is. And then it's smaller. And then actual factual, we go down, here's the numbers. We go up from the numbers, and then we have that object and those two stars, objects, shadows, which will be the same size as the object. And if you don't believe me, go look at what I showed you off the Jupiter picture with the moon of Io, okay? And if you haven't been watching my videos, then you need to go in and take a look at all my videos. So here we go, and we're gonna zoom in on these stars here also. And you'll know and see the signature of that it's stars. And as I get screwed over, but now I'm gonna zoom back in and handle back over to there and this. And when we draw out, you'll be able to see. And now I'm going to zoom in some more on these stars here. And I got to recenter it. And I'll zoom in some more. And these objects and these shadows and these stars are there. And there's two stars for damn sure. And basically what this comes down to is we're going to go to the mass up by the sun here in a second. Whoops. Touched it too fast. And here we come. There we are. We're back. And there you are. And then basically those are two stars. You can keep zooming in on this and you'll get the feature of it of being the stars, a couple stars, just like how I was able to show. And we always knew that the atmosphere on Mars was thinner than Earth's. And that's how NASA didn't realize. I just don't understand how they were so stupid not to realize the idea that if you have a thin atmosphere. And then I just zoomed in on the pictures and we ended up knowing for sure. And there we are, hella zoomed in. You see the percentage. And that's from a 900 zoom off of what they zoom in, and off of, and there's two stars and a bunch of objects that are huge in total what they're blacking out, because as you can see, they're giving a nice blackout image right here. Here, this goes a little bit too much and getting too a little bit too far away from that star to really believe, but that it could be connected, but it could be. There could be an object that's here that's this large, putting that shadow out there. But no matter what, the grouping of planets here and that is making that shadow, and also this shadow here that you see in this. And then that's why they always talk about asteroid belts and stuff like that, because there's stars in asteroid belts, and then there's objects that are, you know, that they're there because they put those shadows off. So now we're going to zoom out of this real fast here, so that you realize that what I was looking at, I was looking at this object here and here, and then I'm gonna go take you to the website. If you can put two and two together, you'll start figuring stuff out, because this is done for a reason. Okay, so now, and so where did I get this from? I'll basically zoom out a little bit and we'll show you where I got the shot from. See how it's all the way up at 900 to start out with, and you can just zoom in and zoom in and zoom in. And there's where I'm going. So, and as you can see, I'll show you the distances here. You'll be able to see it. You should be able to watch this on full screen to be able to read all this down here. C2 takes it at roughly around 5.25 million miles away from the sun. So then you realize, and then you also get a C3 image. Now, what this one here is, this is the latest SOHO MIT EIT teams putting their shot together. Okay, and then you get what's actually going on around the sun, and then you get the sun miffed out, so that the idea that you do not, and that's the size of the sun right there, is that white ring, okay? That is the size of the sun. Okay, now let's, basically I'll blow this up and we'll take a view, and basically what I was looking at is our objects that we have around here that stay here and don't not move out of area, and also here, and I'll go back to the mass object that we have up there. Basically, it's an asteroid belt. It's not just one massive object. So let's play this here, just so that you can see. This is where I was zoomed in on all this stuff from. I get the player to work okay. There was a little bit of technical difficulties there, but right now what I want to do is basically show you this, and notice the spiking in the dramatic. This was basically, I was wanting to show you what I had a little bit earlier. Earlier today, we had a lot of what we're beginning to be back to right here. We had it along, all the way along the graph. And basically, it was, the solar wind was basically doing a lot of what you're basically seeing up here. And, but it was doing it in speed, and it was doing speed shifts of up and down and up and down a lot. So we're going to have some more. We did have a C recently and everything like that. And if I got enough time, we'll go into the freshest, what we got for going on. And basically, every time I pop into one of these, this is the freshest also. So basically, what I was showing you was a LASCO shot of what we have going on with our sun out there. Okay. And I'll go ahead and we'll open up a LASCO C2 here. And here I reloaded the video, and basically, we'll be able to play it again here in a second. And I think I should be able to drop out so you'll see that. There you go. This is the actual factual. And this is our objects down here, and it'll just keep playing. This is our objects that stay here by the sun and rotate around the sun slower like Earth does. Okay? So, no matter what, these smaller stars in these objects are within a belt area. I'm not sure yet if they are in our Earth belt that is going around the sun that we stay in stereo drive on. But no matter what, they're pretty much as slow as Earth or slower than Earth, and they're always going to stay in stereo play, you would think, from what we know. Now, we do know that there's stars that spin around 700 times the size, the speed of the sun turning around, because the sun does turn around also, rotates around so many days. Or actually hours. And I'm trying to remember now. This is Sundays or hours. So anyhow, these objects stay stagnant there, as you see, because this video will keep playing. And these are the objects, basically they're stars and masses of bodies of planets that are there because they put the shadows off. Stars don't put shadows off. So these here, this stays here all the time. This stays here all the time. Up here where our mass object is at, which we may have a mass object that we've been seeing. And as you see, they black out an object there too. So that one area that I'm doing a video, you can watch, because basically at a certain time they don't want you to see a certain something that is right, and it'll black out at the beginning of the video, I believe, because it'll just keep playing. And there you go. See, so there's basically something going on in this area that they're not wanting us to see. Now, that could be our mass object. It could have moved a lot, and it's huge. It's up here. And we do have the meatball that's out there also that we can see on the very far away shot from a stereo ahead shot. Okay? So let's get out of this video. Now, pretty much what I believe is the idea of the mass object that was over there to the right, and this is a snapshot, and I'm going to go over to paint real fast. And as I go to paint, we will get, this is our mass star up to the right of the sun, okay? But it's not the one that you normally see. It's not the meatball. It's not the mass 4250 or whatever. This is another mass, because you're going to see as we zoom in here, basically there's stars. And the one is huge that's normally we see that they always try to tell us it's a piece of, hang on. Okay, so I'm zooming in on our basically stars and a dark objects in the asteroid belt that's basically up to the right hand side of the sun. As you can see that we are basically, there's the sun there, and we'll move to the right and we'll just keep zooming in. You'll see that there's two stars there, and there's actually three. You start looking closer, you see. So this is not our massive object that they're normally blacking this out. This is basically another asteroid belt or objects, planets behind stars, because stars usually have planets. Now Earth is hiding out like a rabbit in a hole, and that basically I'll just keep zooming in this, and then I'll be able to zoom back out. And basically you just take time to back up the video and look up to the right hand side, upper right hand side of the sun, because there's the sun there, lower left, and then there's these stars up there, and then there's planets or objects, because we have darkness behind. And like I've said, it's an actual fact that the idea that a object, basically planet in space, will have the same size shadow. It's not like when you're in front of a light bulb yourself humanistically where you can make huge shadows. We can adjust light here on Earth that we have artificial and make shadows, but natural light in space, the object will have the same size shadow as itself. So if there's a huge shadow, they know there's a huge object. And now we zoomed in on these stars pretty good. I'll go to the max here to the right, and we'll see what kind of image we get. And there you go, and those are stars. Now, what I'll do is, I think I actually screwed up and bumped out, and I did. I bumped out of the way of where the stars are at there on that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to minus down real big, which as you can see, I've on paint. And then I'll just go back in on them. Over here to the right, we'll zoom in, and pretty much I think we're getting low on video time, but we'll see what else we can get put in here. And then I'll zoom in on those stars again. And like I say, this is not that big piece where they kept on saying, you, well, it's just a piece of lint or something like that on the lens or stuff like that. This is not it. There's just some shadows that are huge, but there are planets that are huge, because basically when you see how far they are away from the sun, and then they're putting off that big of a shadow up by these stars, and I'll keep on zooming into them. And you'll know that I'm back right where we were at, and now I'm going to come back out. And we've got our shot, and there's the sun, and there's our objects, and there's our shadows, and there's planets up there. Planets, and remember, Mercury is the same size as the moon. Mercury is actually a moon, okay? But it's out in the middle of nowhere by itself. It would be interesting to study what's around by Mercury, because Mercury is interesting in the factual of what kind of luminosity that it puts off that we see from Mercury. That's the one interesting thing. It's quite close to what the luminosity that the moon puts off also. So there you go. There's your picture, and that was from the same video. And forget about living on Mars. That ain't going to happen. Like I've told you people, don't ever be talked into go living on Mars. Now, these other ones, you still got to watch that too. We've got to keep on studying what we have out there. And this is the hottest topic right now here. Other than that, so an antiquities black market dealership got busted, and there is a basically old mummified, basically baby. And it's getting to be more well known that the idea that we were probably down in Peru way before we were in the ancient pyramids over in the Middle East. Basically, grave robbing is what it takes to find out where intelligence first was on the face of the earth. And anyway, this is what's going on with this. And then you really got to know, okay, can we have a look at it and know if it's really real? Okay. But anyway, more than likely, the pyramids wasn't first. I got this from Astrobiology Magazine, and that's not where I first got it. I have a better source for it. Basically, they're not even really telling you the truth right here. So, stay tuned for the truth, because the truth is a lot closer than what you believe, okay? Now, for the electricians, the astrophysicists, and the intelligent people that come to my site, eventually we're going to get into some of this, and also we're going to get into a lot of basically traveling through space in a protective tube, okay? But you also got to pay attention to this, okay? And this. HD 40307. They're playing games with you, folks.